Oh, she kind of has a little bit of red in her hair, don't you?
Yeah, it's more obvious.
Yeah.
Am I on the that's quite bad. That was not his sister. For his older, his younger one.
So has the Globe said anything about the report?
Or no, no, no.
George Grohman, one of my favorite people in the world. Remember that name? Can you listen to that?
Can you bring him in with Rolls Royce?
Nice to see you.
How are you?
I once made a joke at his expense. It was a phenomenal reaction. Popped out. I apologize. I'm sorry, you're so thin skinned.
Whoever wants to know that. Jenny Casey.
Shocking. We have traffic here. Wow.
I actually wasn't too bad today. I was coming out of home from Boston last night. It's wicked. All the construction. Wicked. How are you?
Emily, have you now moved up in the chain?
No.
Are you taking over this task?
Every morning, the agency save a lot of money. No, you want to pass out pictures.
Yeah, she came home pretty late.
Yeah.
And she had, she had.
Comfortable, and then, my grandparents, her mom, my dad, it came up yesterday.
O'Brien and grandma. What was that guy's name? Radio House?
Yes, my dad, so it's probably good. Yeah, she,
I've been following up on the case.
She's.
She was a cat house.
Yeah, you told me that.
She's so exhausted.
Yes, she is.
Just from doing so much prepared, for sorry for time off.
So let me ask you a question.
Eventually, I have to hear something so long.
Speaking of, we're gonna be the same.
For her, which is like, maybe she expect for her to change, so.
Either that, or you can say, opt you down, settle that case, you gotta hurry.
Yeah.
What color is your grandma?
What?
Really?
What's that, what are you gonna do?
You just have a nice.
So you're gonna like, yeah, she's probably read, I was like, can you show on Netflix? Yeah. I know she'll. She needs a mentor.
Yes.
So that's a good.
Yes, they like.
A lot of friends looking up.
Cause like, I'm not.
Flower.
So I was like looking up pictures after.
It's made out of,
And I was like, oh. Yeah, no, for sure. Yeah.
What?
That's a lot, that's a major question.
How are you, Joe?
Good. How are you?
You gonna control this a bit?
Can't control it. You do?
Really?
No, it's good. How are you?
It was school.
My guy, he was working out.
Yeah.
July 3rd.
You know, I know. But still, just on.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, first.
You said it.
Alright.
Is I ready?
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Hi, how are you?
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Good.
Most astute political mind in the room.
Hey, how do you find somebody?
From?
Rescue?
Oh, yeah.
Must get some people. Must maybe.
Probably. Oh, is he front, or who's he front of? Wind?
He is with the.
What with his dead hand? Oh, wow, he got, he's in heaven. Lobbyist?
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't remember. But you're not related to the other program, but he's in the C.
No, I don't say that, just.
He lives in the C.
He retired. He is. He won't pay us. I know. Danny Holmes. That's a dick. His son was.
ideas are we going?
George Bush. Oh, I like that. You know.
First of all, where do you?
No, I'm gonna tell that, because it's all my.
Michael out there?
Yes.
You want, yeah, you want to bring him in?
bring it rolling.
All right, let's get it rolling.
Right, George? I won't interrupt again.
On it here, ladies.
The best seats in the house.
Couple weeks ago.
Oh,
Yeah, I remember that.
Where you went to school. That's my college. Our arch rival, he knew she was down.
Teacher. Yeah.
All right, let's go.
Yeah.
Next week's the 4th of July.
Morning, everyone. Apologize for starting a little bit later than our originally scheduled. I know traffic was difficult for some of us to get in. Good morning. I'm nominating to the guests, witnesses. Good morning to my colleagues. It's about by introducing the council. My right is Councilor Joseph Ferreira, Councilor Robert Jupiter.
Good morning.
So the question I have
case that the defendant deserves a break, he will get that break from my flesh.
But sometimes, as you well know, there are judges who say that, and then they go sit on a bench, but they never put the word not in front of him.
We understand that. No. He's been going off a lot of trials. Well, he's working for me 12 minutes, 11. He's
seen
him. He knows how to say it. He will know how to say it. And he will not
if it's the right.
And he, if it's the right, and he will not avoid the jury trial like some of them do. Because the newspaper may get involved in all this.
A citizen has a right to a jury trial, so it chooses. That's a matter of law. Okay, I appreciate it. Thank you.
Can I go home?
That's all right, no.
Not quite.
You told me to be brief.
List of questions. Bouillet. Kidding. I've known Howard, his family, Howard's father served on the council, was a very good friend of my father's, his mother, his whole family. I've known Howard's family for 30, 40 years.
You gave your brother free ice cream.
And you gave me free ice cream in Hummerock. Howard had the ice cream. Just to let you know, sir, when your name came before the council, you were nominated by Governor Baker. The first call I got right away was Howard Hayes. Howard knows what a good lawyer is. Howard and I practiced way back when in the DMC, and we were hard workers. Remember Saturdays, waiting for our name to be called. Howard knows a good judge. I think he can be an outstanding judge. I don't have any questions of Howard. Good to see you again. You got a good man here, you're going to lose him at the Commonwealth. It's the Commonwealth. Good to see you.
Thank you.
Thank you
very much. I appreciate it.
Good to see you.
Thank you.
Next, this is Stephen Poitras, Clerk Magistrate. Welcome to the court. Welcome back.
Thank you.
Is this your first time back?
Yes, my first time back. It was not that long ago. Good morning, Councilor Casey, members of the council. Again, my name is Steve Poitras. I'm the Clerk Magistrate of the Waltham District Court. Thank you for allowing me to be here this morning to speak on behalf of my friend and colleague, Michael Welch. I've known Michael for over 25 years, having first met him back in 1991. We were both fledgling sole practitioners doing bioethical work on the Worcester District Court. Back then, I had the opportunity of 8 years to really observe him on a daily basis. I have observed him interacting with judges, court staff, other lawyers, and his clients. More recently, I have had the opportunity to observe him at the Waltham District Court, where he has appeared on numerous occasions. I have seen him do anything from representing clients on CMDI hearings or clerks hearings to trial work. Members of the council, in my opinion, the governor made an excellent choice when he decided to nominate Michael to a seat on the district court bench. I believe he has all the qualities that we look for in a district court judge. He is a person of integrity and unquestionable character. He is someone who is patient and understanding. He is somebody who is compassionate and open-minded, and he possesses the courage make difficult decisions, even though they may not be popular. Look at his resume, you will see that he has a wealth of experience on both the civil and criminal side of the law. For 10 years as a sole practitioner, he concentrated on criminal defense work. Subsequent to that, for 17 years, he worked at two different law firms, all of which concentrated on civil litigation, but also continued to do criminal work. Michael Welch is somebody who always exercises good judgment. He is somebody who has exceptional legal skills. He is somebody that has, in my view, the demeanor and temperament necessary to be a district court judge. Again, I think he has all of the qualities that one would look for in a district court judge, and I would urge you to vote favorably on this confirmation.
First of all,
So you're, so have you seen the
Back in the early 90s, when I was in the West District Court, I saw him every day. For a period of 8 years, I saw him every single day. Since that time, he's been there on numerous occasions. I can't give a number, but I have seen him represent clients on many occasions, on criminal application hearings, and I've actually seen him in trial.
If you could use one adjective to describe his mind.
I think he's a person with integrity.
wanted to also, most importantly, thank my wife, my daughter, my son, Zachary, who could not be here today. He's actually starting a new job in the last semester in the Assumption College Master's Program in Counseling and Psychology. He's actually been married in August. Just a little bit of background about me. I grew up in Grafton, Massachusetts, one of nine children. I was actually tied for fifth and sixth with my twin Mark. My father and mother, they came from Lynn and Saugus, originally moved to Grafton just before I was born. My father was a lawyer for over 50 years. He loved the law. He loved being a lawyer. He inspired not only myself, but my sister and two brothers, as well as a nephew, to become lawyers. My father worked very hard, but still found the time to be a very good father. He always gave me help in going through law school, and was always there to bounce ideas off and discuss a particular case. He worked full time right up until the time of his death a couple of years ago. In fact, he was coming from a real estate closing. My mother worked very hard. She had a large family. She took care of us. As we got older, she actually worked with my father as a secretary for him and his firm. I think she died actually a few months before him and got Alzheimer's. I know they would both want to be here today, especially my father, who always had a dream of having one of his children sitting on the bench. Their incredible work ethic is still going to be the same. I started working in the workforce back when I was 12 years old, working 28 as a vegetable farm. I worked some 70 hours a week, making about 95 cents an hour, but I loved the work. Continued on working at different farms throughout high school, as well as college. I worked at Burger King and Iandoli Supermarket, obtaining shift supervisor positions in each job. After getting my accounting degree at Assumption College, I did work for a CPA as well at law school in Westboro doing accounting and individual corporate tax returns. My dream to become a lawyer started the first time I saw my father actually try a case up in Westboro Court. I was probably 13. I remember the trial of the day representing a police officer that had some trouble up to me, and I was mesmerized by the jobs of all the attorneys, the judge, as well as the whole process. That day forward, it was only one job, a lawyer and a judge. I have worked civil, criminal, as well as a whole array of different parts of the law. If confirmed, I'm confident that my experience, my work ethic, both my values, assist me in becoming a good judge. Judge Bowman. Thank you.
Well done. Now I'm going to open it up to my colleagues. If anybody has any questions, I will start with I'm going to start with Counselor Jupiter.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
the only thing I didn't hear you thank was the veterans.
Why did I write it first? Was
there something I didn't hear?
I can tell you what the first sentence was, I think, that Casey for...
So what do you think? What do you think our job here is?
Your job is to make sure that qualified judges...
Right. So we do the hiring. Governor just nominated. So I'm very touchy about candidates that get the governor's counsel. These candidates that become judges and clerks and retire. Thank everybody under the sun, including the janitors in this building, but they forget the people who gave them the job.
Again, my apologies.
If you're nominated and if you're confirmed, and I go to your retirement party, I would hope that you would remember the governor's council that gave you the job. Thank you. So a couple things I wanted to ask you. You cited a bunch of cases in your application. cases that you won. Did you ever lose a case?
Yes, I did. I think some of those were mentioned in the other section.
You didn't. You didn't want to tell us about them.
I think the question you were directed towards was actually the